Today we're talking all about cutovers. And you might notice that I'm sitting in a boat right now in my carport. This is a boat that we actually just purchased with the Southern Outdoorsman. We actually, as a company, just purchased this boat. So you're gonna be able to follow along with us as we kind of fix this thing up. I'm sure we're gonna be doing plenty of crappie, bass, and catfishing out of it this summer. And then of course, we're gonna be deer hunting out of it this fall. I'll link the video to this boat down in the description below of where we got it, because we want your suggestions on what we should do with this boat to rig it out for hunting purposes. But let's talk some deer hunting. We've gotten some really good feedback on these last few mapping videos that we've done, so we wanted to do another one more specifically about cutovers. Obviously, we're from the South, and cutovers are a really big deal to a lot of people who hunt in the South. If you hunt pretty much anywhere in like the Pine Belt, you know, like Louisiana, South Arkansas, Mississippi, Georgia, Alabama, Florida, South Carolina, you're gonna be dealing with a lot of pine trees and a lot of timber. And cutovers are just a part of life down here. Mastering the cutover is gonna really help you become a better deer hunter. We're gonna just go over one of my favorite setups when it comes to cutovers. Let's take a look at the map here. This is here in the South. I don't even remember what state I'm in right here, but I think this is in Arkansas or Mississippi, somewhere like that. As you can see, there's just a ton of diversity right here. We got a lot of different streams coming down. We've got a lot of different habitat types, which include some pines of all different ages. We got some cutovers, some older cutovers, some newer cutovers, and we got some hardwoods. You can also see food plots all over the place here. We're gonna be looking at this spot specifically right here. The reason I really like this spot so much is because obviously this is a cutover, this is a cutover, and this is also a cutover with an interesting, like a little pine plantation here at the tip of this cutover as it drops down. That's something a little bit different, but all these cutovers are pretty much the same age, it looks like. This one in the middle might be like a year older, and the way you can tell is, we'll zoom in on these cuts. This looks like it's probably just like broom sedge and stuff like that, some grasses. And this looks like the same thing, but it looks thicker. So it looks like there's more grass here as opposed to more dirt over here possibly. You can see like patches of dirt through here and it just looks a little bit thinner, where this is like that nice kind of golden carpet of sage grass. So one thing that catches my eye about this spot is this is a compounding feature. If you're a longtime listener of the podcast, you heard on episode 141 with Josh Driver talking about compounding features. Compounding features don't have to just be terrain features. They can also be habitat and terrain features. So this is a compounding feature for a lot of reasons, but mostly because we have a thermal hub right here. So this is a thermal hub, and we've got some videos on thermal hubs that you guys can go check out that I'll also link below, where it meets all these cutovers. So all these cutovers are like falling down into that thermal hub. They all come down on points into that hub, which is a real kind of, I think, recipe for success, because these cutovers are gonna hold a lot of deer, and specifically they're gonna hold a lot of does. And so for the rut, this is just gonna be a dynamite spot. Something about these ditches that come down out of these cuts, like this right here. Here's another one actually. This isn't in the thermal hub, but this ditch right here actually looks phenomenal. I've had really good luck in ditches like this where you just have like a large drainage coming down out of the middle of that cutover, and it empties out somewhere. And wherever it empties out is usually a pretty good spot, because you will have deer travel down that ditch, and you also have deer cut across the front of it. So you tee off right there, and that's where that activity is. So that's a really good looking spot. Another thing that I like about this is, again, this tip right here. The tip of this cut is these planted pines, and that's gonna give you so many more edges. I mean, really the name of the game here is habitat edges, and that's why cutovers are so good. Kind of like I mentioned earlier in this video, we got hardwoods, we got pines, we got cutovers. All those things are different, and where those things meet, where all the different cover types meet, that's a habitat edge, and deer are creatures of edge, so you're gonna find deer on edges. And so it kind of stands to reason that the more edges you have in one area, the more deer you're probably gonna find. And so if we just look at this image right here, I mean, just think of all the edges that you have right here. I mean, you have the edges between the cutovers and the hardwoods. You got an edge where this specific SMZ right here is made up of more pines than hardwoods. That's gonna be a very specific habitat type. and it's going to be different than the hardwood SMZs around there. There's probably going to be different plants growing in it. There's probably going to be like honeysuckle and stuff growing down in the bottom, right in between these two cuts. So you're going to have thick cover with good food in between them, with more thick cover like in that SMZ, because that's such a skinny SMZ. The SMZ itself is probably also thick. So again, if we just look at this area and we kind of highlight all the different edges, that's what makes this a good spot. And as far as setting up in a spot like this, it's kind of hard to decide where exactly to sit without being in there. But honestly, when you approach a spot like this, the best thing to do is just go in there and hit some of these edges and just walk them out and see what you see on the ground. You know, from a map image, you could maybe go in blind in this spot. And if I was just literally just gonna go in blind, I would probably sit honestly somewhere right here around this pin, right here maybe at the opening of this skinny pine SMZ right here, where this is also like a older cut. This is actually where they planted pines in an old cut, and you can see them growing in. But look at all these gaps between the trees. Look at how much space there is in between all these trees. That means that that is going to also be thick right now. So you've got fresh cut over, slightly older cut over with grass in it, older, very, very, very thick pine thicket with an SMZ right between all three of them that runs down to this spot where that pin is. If I was just going in blind, I would probably sit pretty much right where that pin is. If I was going in for an afternoon hunt, I'd probably get out there at like 11 a.m. and just go ahead and eat lunch before, or bring a lunch with me, go out there and just walk around and just ease through here and maybe check out this edge. And then depending on what things are looking like, maybe even push up in that SMZ a little bit and just see what it looks like, because honestly, this edge right here looks really equally as good, especially because, as you can see, there's a subtle saddle that cuts this little cutover in half, and you have this edge right here that's also going to kind of guide movement. So this is just a very, very interesting area, and we're going to be doing some more videos in the near future about actually going out and looking at these spots in person. But from a map scouting perspective, this looks like a home run and definitely something that I would consider going and actually checking out in person. We had some luck in an area very, very similar to this back in January in South Alabama. We were able to actually kill two nice bucks in a setting that was very, very, very similar. We had ditches coming out of cutovers. We specifically targeted those ditches and we were catching bucks, chasing does, or cruising down those ditches. So definitely go check out spots like this. If you got any questions on this, make sure you drop them in the comments below. Any other mapping ideas that you'd like to see us tackle, make sure you hit those in the comments below as well. And we'll do our best to get them, especially in this kind of springtime off season, while we all got our wheels turning about last season. We're gonna be knocking out some of these mapping videos to make sure that you're equipped to go out over the summer and early fall and go out there and find exactly what you're looking for and start your deer season on the right foot. So thanks everybody for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe to this channel for more content. And we'll see you back here on the next video from the Southern Outdoorsman.